What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome to The Word. As always, on the left side of your screen, that is COVID Smalls.
Yo, yo, yo.
Holding it down in the middle is COVID D.
Not anymore.
And I am your host, COVID ODY, sponsored by Soundcheck, soundcheckdenver.com, where Denver bands and musicians have practiced their passion since 2014. And guys, we're going to mix it up with a new segment on this episode of The Word. We're going to go with the traditional format, weekly highlight, late night deep cut to finish it off. But in the middle, we're going to get a new segment going.
Well, you know, it's part of the contract.
Yeah, we we are up to our eyeballs in legal obligations that we are not coming through on. So we're going to check one of 20 off today. Then in the next episode, we might consider doing another one.
You know, Ziggy's Coffee, sponsor me. We need some help around here.
Yeah, some sponsors would help, because I think the stress gets to us and we just bog down and we can't handle anything.
No, that was the COVID.
Oh, right.
COVID.
So shout out to COVID. And also shout out to our beloved segment that kicks off each and every episode of The Word, the weekly highlight. We're starting off with a bang today. More specifically, Fredo Bang, this is Addy. Robbie D, just drop it right now. Let's go.
Hey, Fredo or Fredo? Blood, you forgot the beat.
Yeah, he didn't forget the Fritos, because it's not Fritos, it's Fredo.
They're just in the studio and made this video, bro.
That's a pretty wild looking studio.
Bright ideas.
Yeah,
bro, he needs to be able to see the bitches, bro. If she fucked the whole gang, she a
member. And if that pussy got some eyes in this room, he's having a lot of fun.
Yeah, a lot of fun, but he just mumbles away, though. She said,
can I fuck on my phone? It's all quiet.
Oh, yeah, I'm supposed to be rapping. I don't like no
boom, bitch. I like him. Yeah, because he's getting distracted. Be like, damn, look at what she's doing back there. Oh, damn. He said Adderall like three times.
He wants some Adderall, bud.
This who tripping?
Wash it down with some tea.
Some lean. What is that move?
What the fuck?
Hey, he's having way too much fun here.
He's like, bitch, get off my piano.
It's the Adderall that's got him going.
He's like Filthy Smalls on that 20 ounce coffee.
Oh, this thing, I asked for a large, man. Yeah, I didn't even know.
What you some Adderall?
This one right here, it's probably like, I'm guessing, like 4:30 in the morning. He's like, all right, let's just make a music video already. Come on,
fucking go, man. Let's go. Let's get some booty shaking. Let's get some bright lights. And let's fucking do it.
See, that's kind of what Smalls wants to do. He wants to record a song, drop the video all in the same day.
Facts. Is that too much to ask for?
Work smarter, not harder. That's what I always say.
Two birds with one stone.
Yeah.
But we now know that Fredo Bang loves Adderall.
Yeah, the Fredo Bang, not to be confused with Fredo Bag.
Fredo Bag. I kind of do got the... I'm hungry, bro.
You got the munchies now?
That's why it was Fredo.
You don't want to get some Fritos after this, though.
You don't want to take Adderall on an empty stomach. That's what I've heard.
Yeah, but too much Fritos will hurt your stomach.
Yeah. You got to balance it out. Get that 4:30 a.m. tequila going.
Yeah, 4:30. You know, it was like 4:30. Yeah. He already looked fucked up, bro.
4:30.
Rise and shine, motherfuckers.
I don't know. That's like way past my bedtime.
That's practically past your awake time.
That is almost my wake time, for real.
That pretty much is the wake time.
Oh, my God.
Up and early. Got to get it.
Yeah, I don't...
He's doing Adderall.
Yeah, if I'm up by past 4:30, I might as well just stay up and not go back to sleep.
I can see that.
Say no to Adderall.
But don't, do you say no to Fredo Bang?
Yes, I say no.
You do? Not feeling it?
Not really. He just mumbled his way through it, and then he just said, Adderall, Adderall, Adderall.
Too much Adderall?
Too much? That's a...
He did kind of quit during his verses. He's like, I'm coming to get it.
I'm just going to remix and make a fentanyl one then.
Fentanyl, fentanyl, fentanyl.
That's not really...
Yeah, that's not as jovial of a subject.
You don't. Yeah, people are fucking dying off that shit.
But they're still trying it, though.
So speaking of trying, here's what we're going to try right now, right here. We are going to try to see if a new segment lands. And we're actually going to call it Did It Land? So the premise of this segment, fellas, see, I'm pitching this to these guys right now. This is catching them totally off guard. We didn't have a script for this episode.
He just kind of pulled it up just now.
Yeah. The total surprise.
He's like, hey, got a new segment, by the way. Blah, blah, blah. Hey, bam.
But, let's go.
I still don't know what's going on.
Never does. But we're going to do a segment called Did It Land? And for the first thing we're going to look at, we're going to use this segment to hone in on a rapper that might be doing a new approach, maybe a new sound, a new experiment, a new concept, or something like that. But what Robbie D wanted to focus on for this first one is he saw the recent stuff that was going on between The Game and Eminem, and he wanted to pose the question about The Game's diss track and his online barbs going at 50 Cent, Eminem going at everybody. See if all that stuff landed, and we're going to take a look at some of this stuff that The Game's been putting on. So, Robbie, if I pass it off to you, if you just want to give a quick rundown of where The Game stands in this whole thing.
Okay, first of all, if you're trying to ruin your career, most definitely go after Eminem. I mean, it's been shown before. He's going to put all his resources towards ruining your fucking career just because you dissed Eminem. Second of all, why are you going to make a 10.5-minute song on a diss track? Like, what? You have so much to say. I mean, you guys probably need therapy with each other.
Or fight.
Probably therapy with each other.
The therapy would last longer than the fight.
Yeah.
Just saying.
But I'm just saying, it's like you have way too much to say. Why did he hurt your feelings, first of all? And second of all, you purposely trying to ruin your career by making a 10-minute fucking song.
And the song is called?
Oh, The Black Slim Shady.
So The Black Slim Shady, as Robbie D says, 10.5 minutes long. Way too long for a song. Way too long for anything. So right off the bat, that doesn't land. That's just not cutting it.
Yeah.
And we're not going to be able to hold your attention as a faithful viewer of the word for 10 minutes of The Game. So we're going to fast forward, get a couple minutes into this, and jump right into one of the 17 verses, I think it is, whatever it is. We're going to jump ahead a little bit and get a little clip of The Black Slim Shady to see The Game. Did it land?
So we're entering in at 2 minutes if you guys want to follow through. The hook. I killed Dr. Dre in my basement last night. I was wasted last night. I went apeshit last night. Chopped his body up and forgot where I placed it last night. Had a slice of humble pie.
Why are you going after Dr. Dre, though? Lost my
taste and my smell. Lateral damage. Innocent bystander.
I don't know, because Dr. Dre's got a lot of resources, too. Going dumb, not E40 to other 40. I'm with Canadians at Drake House having a stakeout. I think the game is all in his feelings with this one.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, you're going after Drake, you're going after E-40. Trying not to go after E-40, but when I see Lizzo on the internet, another
BBL, my dick get little on the internet. You think that he was doing some Adderall with Mr. Bang?
Yeah, he took too much Adderall, so he started listing everyone in The Game right now.
Hey man, let's get you out the
and trying to go after. Good looking, I
how's your night going, bro?
I think his feelings got hurt from everybody in the rap game right now.
This is where hate and spite gets you as a man. Just you put up way too big of a project that so far has not landed. That shit hard as
fuck. Crazy story behind it.
So, brother Stan, another part of it that stuck out to me right away is the how he's parodying.
Yeah, that's a tough word to say.
Yeah, parodying a bunch of Eminem's famous lines and songs and hooks and things like that, and trying to spoof it. But it's like, it's kind of unspoofable material. All due respect.
Hey man, I'm driving. I'll get you there.
That's facts.
He's a make of this song. This is kind of like too much. I'm already falling asleep, bro.
Yeah, that's what I said. You gotta hold people's attention.
But this is kind of why we're not gonna play the whole entire song, because one thing you can never have is my
motherfucking black skin. The beat mixed up. I mean, so we had this a few weeks ago, a few episodes ago, with Robbery Part 1, Robbery Part 2, and Robbery Part 3. See, he was smart. He split it up into three different parts, not one giant movie. Because now suddenly the beat's changed. His flow has changed up a little bit.
Instead of splitting it up into three segments, which would probably have been better,
it could have been an approach.
Yeah. But you know what's getting me is he's trying to do like the white guy voice, like,
right?
You know, which then you're gonna go after Royce the 5'9". Like, that will murder your career.
Everybody's catching strays right now.
But all right, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop it here at 5 minutes. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about it. So I mean, first of all, the white guy voice game. Come on, bro. You should have just been yourself and just do the Thug Dizzle shit instead of fucking changing your style up.
Yeah, like I said, it's a spoof that just, I mean, if you're gonna spoof something, it's got, you gotta execute on it. And it sounds like to Robbie D, he didn't.
Nah, I mean, just the segment's called Did He Land It? I don't think he fucking landed anywhere near the spot he was supposed to be at.
It didn't land.
It was like he was just spraying around, and then all the big guys were just like, oh, that doesn't even get close to touching me. What are you talking about, weird little guy?
Just let it fly.
Yeah. So, I mean, yeah, he's just, look, he says sit, snitch nine, like.
Oh, is that like. I'd rather listen to snitch nine.
Like, you're taking shots at, I'm assuming, Tech N9ne? Because I don't know anybody else with a 9.
Well, it's stylized as 9, but I guess he's talking about our guy.
Your guy? Not my guy, your guy.
Somebody's got to claim him.
Some Tech N9ne?
No.
Tech N9ne, Tekashi.
Oh, yeah. That's it. But he was over there backing him up. What are you talking about? When he was going through trial, the game had his back. Oh, it was on Bloods and shit. You know, and then all of a sudden, dude snitches. Now you don't want to fucking wrap him up?
But he said that he would rather listen to Snitch 9 than Eminem.
Yeah, but he's catching a stray calling him Snitch 9.
But he's going to, I thought my went way off. I thought Tech N9ne was going to murder him. But.
Yeah, because of the 9, it's stylized on the screen.
Nobody for real is not going to go after Tech N9ne, though.
No, that's what I'm saying. He'd be fucking
if
stupid.
If he caught a stray on this, it would have been way out of left field.
Yeah, facts. I mean, but I'm just saying, because the game, they're all, like, gang-related pretty much, right?
Okay.
I'm assuming, allegedly.
Allegedly.
So, I don't know, I feel like the game is just trying to ruin his fucking life right now.
Burn it all down.
I mean, you might as well go hard or go home.
But he's not really going that hard, though, to be honest.
He's not.
That's part of the problem.
He's missing every punch.
Just swinging wild.
And why didn't he make a 10-minute song strictly about Eminem if he was dissing Eminem? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because he can't. He's afraid.
So he's still scared in his diss?
So our next segment that we debut on the next episode of The Word is going to be the therapy session, where we're going to psychoanalyze lyrics and songs. And I don't. We're going to have to dig up a therapist to help us get through this. What is the trauma that is leading the game to do this?
I think I have a theory on that.
What is it, Robbie D?
Because everybody he's going after is underneath the Interscope label, right?
Right.
So, theory is because the game walked away from them. They made a shit ton of money without him because he's stupid and walked away. This is when he went from, when he was having that shit and he went over to Cash Money label. Yeah. So, he lost a lot of money. He got fucked. Now he's sad going after them because they won't let him back in the group.
He should have called himself the Black Walter White then.
the thing is, all I think that he just needs a hug, bro.
Yeah, the game. It's going to be all right. I mean, yeah, there's more money to be made.
Not by him.
Well, aside from you.
Well, you kind of done fucked up your shit, so maybe not.
Yeah, I mean.
So we're 3 for 3 here. Did it land? Zero. No.
No, you fell short.
You fell woefully short.
And 10-minute song. 10 and a half, my bad.
Yeah. That's like...
11 minutes.
I'm trying to find a good analogy here. It's like you turn on a tutorial, like a Photoshop tutorial, and you just skip the whole thing. It's like, no, I just need the steps. I don't need an explainer up in front. This didn't need to be a 12-minute video, seriously.
So he was listening to that crackhead chick. Can I get 11 cents from you? And he thought, can I get 11 minutes from you?
Yeah, that's what it was.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The game is spending way too much. I mean, when you're on Colfax, you don't want to think too hard about what's going on right around you.
You just have to get done with whatever you're doing.
You just got to go. That's the thing.
No, he's going to go. His career is probably done.
It's over. I'm sorry.
If we see the game on the Colfax, then you know what happened.
And if you pull up Filthy's phone right now and pull up YouTube, you're going to get hit with those ads about back pain and the chiropractors.
back hurting, bro.
So when the game is rolling down Colfax, literally, on a wheelchair, and Filthy Small sees him in his wheelchair, he's just going to turn around and go the other way.
Yeah.
That's how it goes.
Sorry, game.
I got to roll.
Welcome to Denver.
Yeah. We don't know how you ended up here, but see you later. So that is Did It Land, our latest segment from the Word. We're going to keep churning out those segments left and right because, as Robbie D points out, our contract clearly states, 69 new segments a year?
Minimum.
I mean, we got to clear that threshold. It would be nice to land on 69, though. Not snitch 9. 6-9.
Yeah, no snitch 9 up in this bitch.
Yeah.
I totally got that. I forgot about it. He's not even on my radar. Like, I don't pay attention to that.
Last guy I was thinking.
Like, I don't consider him a rapper either, so it's just...
Well, there's that, too. So when he makes his big comeback, we're going to have to feature him on Did It Land.
All right, who's he going to snitch on?
I don't know. He's going to... Yeah, is he going to do a...
Everybody?
Fuck.
It's going to be his testimonial rap.
Fuck. Snitch rap, bro? He's going to start a new genre?
Like, flip rap.
Like Filthy Smalls was doing coke with me in the bathroom.
Allegedly.
But not with him. He's going to actually do it, though.
Yeah, it's going to be like diss tracks, but instead of... diss tracks, you're just releasing different refuting things of, like, he has his facts totally misconstrued. He is totally misrepresenting what happened that night. Stuff like that. It's going to be flip rap. Filthy just created a new genre of music.
Yeah.
That's going to play through the legal system for years to come.
I'm completely lost on where we went with that.
But something else is going to be playing for years to come is the Late Night Deep Cut.
Whoa! Oh, finally.
Finally, the Late Night Deep Cut to bring... We always land the Word. The Word always lands.
We got a little out there for a minute, but...
Can you think of an episode of the Word that didn't land?
No. Well...
The first answer was no. Let's stick with that.
No. I had to think about it, like... I mean, we've had a lot of good content and a lot of bad content.
But I don't even remember.
So the good content, you're going to want to stick around for that. As always, like and subscribe. There's a like button somewhere on your screen, or if you're watching on your TV, you can pull out that Roku remote or whatever you're watching on. Get to that like button and just hit it a couple of times. Make sure you stay on the like. If you like it and then unlike it, make sure to like it again. And then you can hit the subscribe button.
Definitely do that.
If you're on your computer or your phone, you can also mix it up in the comments.
Yeah, yeah. We need that.
And if you have a new if you have a new segment idea, with we got to hit that 69 number. We're only at like 13 different segments. I'll do a count after the episode. We'll figure it out.
I think we're actually lower than that.
It might be, but if we've hit double digits, I'll have to do the math. See, it's almost September now. We got a ways to go. We're going to be sweating it out to get to New Year's. But anyways, if you have some new segment ideas, drop it in the comments.
Let us know for sure.
Yeah, yeah. We want some. Yeah, we need some new shit.
But we also need to lean heavily on the old shit, too, which is the late night deep cut.
Oh, that's never going away.
That's never going away. One of these days, we're going to do an episode where we lead off with the late night deep cut. And the middle segment's going to be the late night deep cut. And then we're going to wrap it up with the late night deep cut.
Facts.
That's how we're going to do it. Next episode, tune in.
We might throw a Colfax story in there for you.
just a little bit, just a little. But for this edition of the Late Night Deep Cut, we are turning over to King Ling. This is Pussy is the Bomb 2. Let's drop it.
He made two of these songs?
This is part two.
And I'm remixing this for everybody who left a comment on my song, too.
Remix.
150 comments. I read every last one.
Right, each and every
Hell
one.
Hell yeah. Ignored.
Pussy is the bomb, pussy is the bomb. What? Niggas said my track was trash when I was rapping about your mom. Yeah, y'all jumped all in the comments, time for me to have some fun.
We're, guess it's best we're suddenly stuck in this genre of apartment rap.
Hey, that's where the best songs come out of, like a small house apartment.
This is, this looks like my apartment, really. I'm not hating, I'm just saying, I'm
yeah, less hookers, though.
Right. How you coming me and ugly with your hair and makeup done? Girl, stop playing with me, play with your kids, go find my dad or something. Girl, stop playing with me,
crazy.
Man,
fuck.
I can't keep you one. But I say niggas talking shit, asking me to go subscribe. I'll tell you this.
Send this one looks like he's fucked up, though.
Like. I'm just going to point out that those are definitely not real change.
Give some real advice. Go and why would they be? Come on. Dike, make some shitty songs, and y'all niggas can't even mix it right. Probably can't even mix it right. Apartment, going to be in a bitch for life.
Our guy King Ling, this track is practically an episode of The Haters, right?
Been rapping since in high school, still spam your friends with views. Things should be like you, can't get over 100 on YouTube. Who listen to you?
Even get it over 100.
Yeah, what's wrong with you guys?
Ask yourself, did you come at me or did I come
his
at
eyes
you?
Look, one look, eye looks cricket or something.
He's got that Viper
eye. Oh, he smoked some crack. He's like, all right, I'll give you some crack if you're in my video.
Have me all up in your crib, busting down to my song. Goddamn, leave me alone. You left the comment, huh? Go suck a shift labor condom. Goddamn, leave me alone. I hope y'all hate this one. Pussy is the bomb. Goddamn.
Oh, he finally got around to saying the song, huh?
Go suck a shift labor condom. Goddamn.
It's the remix.
Definitely gonna have to find the first.
Yeah, we gotta go backtrack this.
That's my baby. And y'all sitting here in the comments talking shit. Niggas can't just not like some shit and keep it moving. Gotta put your 2 cents in, huh? Goddamn.
Who's? What I wanna know is who's hating on this?
Bitch.
How can you hate on this?
I don't know.
This one just says bitches.
Who's in the comments bitch hating on King Ling right here? Come on.
Goddamn.
Get your life together.
God damn.
God damn.
That was the bomb. Bitches. King Ling, Pussy is the Bomb, too. God that was damn the bomb. I give that 2 bombs up and 2 bombs down to explode all over.
That's a fact. Just in his apartment, too?
Yeah. The budget was on point, too.
I mean,
pretty cheap. He was going to smoke the crack anyways, but he got the girls to come for the video.
Yeah, damn right.
I'm pretty sure that's just one girl.
No, it's two.
One girl, 2 wigs?
They look like 2 wigs? The same chick with 2 different wigs.
Okay. Two outfits, two wigs. I can roll with that. Like I said, you got to keep the overhead down on these videos.
Let me know what's going on in that video.
You're going to have to give an explainer in the comments for our boy Filthy Smalls.
I'm losing it around here. My contract, I feel, is getting questionable.
It's a vicious cycle. He frets about the contract, and then he drinks way too much coffee.
Ziggy's.
Not enough coffee.
I drank this in like three drinks, bro.
Chuck, 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 chuck. That's how it goes. So we're going to do Pussy is the Bomb Part 3, the remix to the remix, and it's just going to be Filthy spazzing out and pouring sweat.
From the coffee.
Not knowing what's going on.
Facts.
That's how it's going to go.
Pouring coffee on bitches.
That's going to be our late night deep cut video.
It's all fucking hot. They start screaming.
Then we pull out the iced coffee and start throwing ice cubes around.
Hard,
like,
though.
Like, do the dollars and then throw out some ice cubes to cool it down.
No, I'm throwing fastballs, bro.
I'm throwing a whole cooler full. Dump that shit on.
Ice Bucket Challenge 2022. So, it's going down.
Can ice bucket some strippers?
Yeah.
In a small-ass apartment?
In the apartment. We can't do that at the strip club. We would not get away with that.
In a studio?
I'm going to do it in the hallway so my carpet doesn't get all wet. Because if it's all icy, it would take forever to dry.
That's facts.
Yeah. But you know what else? You know what is all dry? This episode of The Word. I think we better pull out some paper towels and wrap it up.
Facts.
Facts. I always wrap it up.
Always wrap it up, kids.
That is also fact.
That is our PSA for this episode of The Word. Wrap it up. So thanks, as always, for tuning in. Until next time, we out.
Peace.
Goddamn. Bitches. Goddamn. Bitches.